So is there politics at play in this big fallout between Trevor Manuel's board at Old Mutual and Peter Moyo, the former chief executive? I mean, does it bust your gut a little bit that Dali Mpofu is having fun at your expense?
It does, but it's not my expense. You've got a board that have considered this matter every step of the way. I don't know the political affiliations of board members. I don't own the board. The board is made up of people who are strong-willed and very experienced. The biggest insult that board members have found is Peter's suggestion in his affidavit that I have them under my thumb. The issue of legal costs because of a successful application that I had for defamation against the EFF. The first assumption that people made is Old Mutual paid my EFF costs.
And Dali Mpofu, of course, is the chairman of the EFF.
He's the chairman of EFF, and so it's word on the street. You listen to talk radio, and this is the stuff that people talk about, but it actually has absolutely nothing to do with those things.
Old Mutual has been clear, just to summarise a little bit, that Old Mutual said that there were legal costs associated with responsibilities that you executed on behalf of Old Mutual. Those legal costs, however, did not come into Old Mutual.
Just in this year, I don't know why I'm so unlucky. I've had three different occasions when I needed lawyers personally. The first was to appear before the Zondo Commission. The second was my action against the EFF. And the third was to respond to a 28-page notice that I got from the public protector dating back to my life as a minister. Those legal costs are for my account. They have absolutely nothing to do with the Old Mutual.
What about the allegations of conflict when it came to your role as deputy chairman of Rothschild South Africa and Rothschild's role as an advisor in the breakup of Old Mutual PLC?
I think conflict is a function of monetary benefit. And also the way in which advisory services runs is governed by the Financial Advisory and Intermediary Services, the FICE Act. Mm-hmm. I can't get into the tank of where advice is given. My role in Rothschild is purely corporate governance role. We have a small board and we oversee in the same way in corporate governance terms what the company does, in the same way as I can't go out on behalf of Old Mutual and sell policies. I can't do that or offer to manage the wealth and investments of Bruce Whitfield. I can't do that. I'm not entitled to do it. And this is no different. So that was a complete red herring. And on the decision, because this is what it was.
So when do we get to the nitty-gritty? When do we get to the facts? When do we get into a courtroom where this matter is properly heard and the real issues are ventilated as to whether or not Peter Moyo is allowed back in this building and whether Old Mutual can move on?
I would love to be able to do that. The judge president of Gauteng, Justice Mlambo, has asked for an expedited appeals process. He's given dates between the 4th of November and the 6th of December for it to be heard and concluded. We are very excited by that. We want to close this issue out. Today there's a meeting with the Deputy Judge President, Mojapelo, because it seems as though Peter Moyo's legal team aren't that keen to get to an appeal stage. We're very confident. We're very confident that a different court will arrive at a different conclusion. Once that is done, I think Peter Moyo's leverage in trying to extract money would be severely limited. We want the appeal to be heard, and we need to ensure that the issues that were so wrong that were put into his affidavit, we need to ensure that those matters are actually resolved once and for all.
Peter Moyo fighting for his reputation and his future career. Do you think your reputation has been damaged in this process?
I think my reputation has been severely damaged.
Would you take personal legal action against Peter Moyo once this was sorted out for the inferences that he has made? I mean,
look, I think that I've reached the point where I'm just actually tired of the protracted nature of all of this legal action. I mean, it's one day after the other. It's one affidavit after the other. It's not going to solve the issues. The reputational damage I've suffered after what I'd like to believe is a lifetime of service is hurtful. But, you know, I'm not going to resolve it through the courts.
Do you feel that there may come a time where you will need to step down as chairman of Old Mutual? Just whether right or wrong, no matter who is right or wrong in this fight, reputations have been so badly damaged that actually it's maybe in the best interest of the company for both Peter Moyo and Trevor Manuel to walk away from this.
That view has been put out there. If the time arises, I'll do it. I mean, just last week, I asked the board to discuss the matter. I stepped away. They invited me back and said that they'd considered the matter. The board doesn't feel the same way as some commentators do, that I should step aside or that the problems will be solved. And they feel this way primarily because I was not the origin of the difficulty. In fact, when the Related Parties Committee started inquiring into this matter, I was kept right out of the loop. Not until it came to the board was I cited on what the issues were. So how do we get to this?
If Peter Moyo says, I'll go if you go, will that solve the problem?
I don't think it solves the problem. I mean, not I'll go, I've left, will you leave too? I think it changes the tenses a little bit.
Trevor Manuel, thank you very much. Trevor Manuel, the chairman of Old Mutual, in one of the most incredible, fractious, destructive battles in South African corporate history. Thank you very much, Trevor Manuel, and thank you very much for watching Taking Stock here on ENCX.